Hello everyone and welcome back to Around the World in 80 Planes and X-Plane 11. For this flight, I'm in the FlyJSIM 727, a payware plane, and I'm flying from San Francisco to Los Angeles. I've decided to go with TWA livery, and so that's how it looks, sort of throwback livery. And the cockpit obviously looks great, aside from the Concorde, one of my favorites. It's got a functional engineering panel and everything. So very good, and yep, we can continue with the Apollo 13 audio. Let me get some flaps started, and Apollo 13, here we go, pressing play. All right. We've got a modicum of flaps. Yeah, especially on the outside. All right. Throttling up. I might want to turn it down a bit. Well, maybe it's not too bad. Once we throttle down for cruise, it'll be better. Oh, okay. It's rotating on its own. I'm not rotating. Well, I guess that's all right. As long as it's not indicative of other imbalances. It's a bit feisty. I'm pitch trimming down here. Okay, flaps down. I mean, flaps up. Definitely flaps up. Okay. Let's see. Well, it said VR 130 V2 142, so yeah. We're headed south. I'm gonna turn the volume down a bit. Come on. A little bit too serious. With the... Oh, I guess I could do it from here too. Okay, here. Okay, we're flying a little bit off there. Okay. Got Foster City there.
Go ahead. Okay, Jack, one thing that I guess you probably all have considered it, but what heavy things can we store down there where the SRC normally go to help increase our already?
I understand the question is what kind of heavy things can you store?
Lift over drag is L over D. Very nice view.
Souvenirs, I guess.
souvenirs. The South Bay, while the East Bay there, and you can see Moffett Field there.
Okay, this assumes that all the descent batteries are online and ascent battery 6 is on normal feed, as we said earlier. First thing you do is go on the CSM and look at panel 5, circuit breaker, LEM power 2, main B.
It occurs to me I better make sure that we've got the cabin altitude right. Always. That's ATC. Okay, we've got bleed air, that's important. Otherwise, this should be automated, I think. Well, here's the cabin altitude and everything.
Okay, what I got, Jack, was the procedure.
Seems to be adjusting.
All descent batteries are on, and bat 6 is on normal feed. Now we go into the limb, and on panel 5, we take limb.
Yeah, I don't think we have any problem there. Alright, just making sure. We've had problems with that before.
Both of them should be main B.
Okay, copy that.
Okay, ready to copy the limp?
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, on panel 16, circuit breaker, EPS, bat feed ties, 2, open. Now you gotta listen real carefully for high volts and low volts. Battery 1, high volts, to off reset. Battery 2, low volts, to off reset and then on. Battery 2, high volts, to off reset, and then on. Battery 1, high volts, on. And then a circuit breaker on panel 16, EPS.
We can see Monterey Bay there. to our right. Brief cloud reset. Last glimpses of the South Bay. And we can sort of see Santa Cruz over there. Sort of at the right wingtip. The peninsula to our forward right is Monterey.
Our entry angle has not changed from its value of 6.24. And somebody calculated that if we had a propulsive vent, that helium could roughly at the maximum only impart delta V of half a foot per second or less anyway. But we're continuing to track, and as soon as we get some more info, we'll pass.
Yep, a bit wiggly. Just want to make sure everything is nominal here. Not going too fast.
Okay, Aquarius, we're ready. So we want some higher bit rate. To do that, go over to panel 16 under COM and close the primary S-band power amplifier on your COM panel. Aquarius, how do you read?
Loud and clear.
Okay, I'm hearing you now. I think I missed your last transmission, Jim.
Okay, Jack is showing Fred the procedures. Wants to get him familiarized with them and how to get out of any problems before we proceed.
Roger, no rush. Just let us know when you're ready. We don't want old Fredo to slip a gimbal there.
go ahead.
Okay, I guess the only question I have is that the very first portion involving the limb there, where it has the turn on.
Oh, the tail skid is still out. Probably busted it when it decided to rotate on its own. I think I've had that happen before.
Okay, I read you until after turn off bat 6. Or correction, turn on only bat 6.
Okay, the question is, we only want one acid battery, bat 6 on the line, immediately followed by turning off 4 decent bats, is that correct?
That's affirmative, Fred. That question's been banging around. We decided to go that way.
Somewhere far, far to the left is Fresno at this point.
Okay, gang, we got the high bit rate now.
Ah, thank goodness for high bit rate.
Okay, we see bat 6 on, and it looks good, Fredo.
Okay, am I clear to proceed with the next step? Get 1, 2, 3, and 4 off reset.
Affirmative, you're cleared for bats 1 through 4 off reset.
Okay.
Okay, still looks good.
Okay, in Houston, we need a call from you when to have Jack proceed up into the up in the Odyssey and start up there.
Okay, where is he? Jack can get with it right now.
Okay. Okay, Houston Aquarius, we've completed the power up and things look good upstairs, so we go for proceeding with battery charge.
Okay, Aquarius, you're going to battery charge.
Roger. This is really a switch, isn't it, Jack?
That's an understatement. You're not known for that.
Yeah, I think if you add up the, operating time, I think the limb beats the CSM by a considerable margin.
Grumman just hired you.
Grumman made the lunar module after all, which is saving them, so.
You're out there at 134,000, coming in at about 4,900 feet a second.
Very good.
The supercrit tank went off at 1937, just about like expected.
Yeah, it also must have not did very much except the rates. I was asleep then and I didn't hear a thing.
Is the command module or service module still venting?
Jack said it was just before he went up. Right now the sun's over there and I can't really tell.
And
I'll look again in a minute.
We asked him a long time ago if he was able to see any stars out the optics. I don't think we ever got an answer.
Okay.
The lake next to us is San Antonio Reservoir Recreation Area. We're headed roughly towards Paso Robles and San Luis Obispo.
And then hook the tie right at the top of the zipper onto the limb upper hatch handle. So it's kind of helpy there. And then just drift it up in the tunnel upside down with my face toward the hatch. So the sunlight didn't get my eyes. And that worked pretty good.
Did you sleep pretty well that way?
Yeah, no problem at all.
That's Fred Hayes talking.
That way now, or is he standing next to you?
He's standing next to me.
About time for him to go to bed.
Okay, the voltage upstairs is 34.3, and the charger is reading 2.5 amps.
Okay, 34.3 and 2.5. And Ecom says that's what you expect.
Pretty cold. Good.
Say again your last.
And they both came down here rubbing their hands, shivering. It's pretty cool up there.
Are you keeping warm in the limb?
Yeah, it's pretty reasonable down here. Right now it looks like the command module is spinning, Jack, so I'm going to try to take a look at the optics.
Okay, did you say it is not venting?
It's totally venting, you just said.
Yep, that's the word. We just looked
through
the
AOC. Or maybe it's not. Okay, I thought I heard him say that it is venting. That's Paso Robles down there. We're roughly following Highway 101.
Completed the transfer of power from the LEM onto the command module main bus B.
Very roughly.
And from there into the battery charger, which is charging battery A, one of the three entry batteries used for entry and post-landing electrical power aboard the command module. The hope is to bring this battery from its current level of 20 amp hours up to about 40 amp hours, which would be essentially a full charge on battery A. And the other two batteries, batteries B and C, already being at full charge. The charging operation on battery A is expected to require about 15 hours, and it began at 112 hours, 12 minutes ground elapsed time. You heard Brad Hayes report that Jim Lovell and Jack Swigert had gone into the command module to power up the battery charger and check on the readings there. When they came back down, Brad said they were rubbing their hands and noted that it was a bit chilly in the command module. At the present time, Apollo 13 is 133,158 nautical miles from Earth, and the spacecraft velocity is up now to 4,891 feet per second. We're 30 hours, 20 minutes, 50 seconds from re-entry. And according to the revised flight plan, at 112 hours, the three crewmen should be getting something to eat. And also you heard Capcom Jack Lausma advise Jim Lovell that it appeared to be about time for him to get a bit of rest.
That's where they keep trying to get Jim Lovell to rest.
Pretty much up to them. Our flight plan on one of the large displays here in Mission Control has some suggested times for sleep, but the crew has generally been working out their own sleep schedules as convenient for them and following it. And we don't have an extremely good idea of when they plan to in advance, but only after the fact when they report to us that they have gotten some sleep. At 112 hours, 21 minutes, this is Apollo Control, Houston.
Aquarius, could you get a amps and volts readout from Odyssey, please?
Okay, stand by.
Okay, so we're flying by San Luis Obispo.
DMP is docked across there. You made the power of permission to get into transfer to the tunnel after the first 1,000 passes.
Get your last there, Fredo. We'd like you to verify that your power amplifier circuit breaker is open.
Yeah, verified. The power amp breaker is open.
Roger.
City to our left is Santa Maria.
Houston Aquarius.
Go ahead, Houston Aquarius.
report from up there that you can see stars in the sun.
And to our right is Vandenberg Air Force Base. Okay, we need to turn a bit to get to Los Angeles because the coast turns. Well, is it a hurricane or a typhoon? 2:00
Yeah, it must be getting around a hill then.
You should start descending.
This is Apollo Control at 112 hours, 50 minutes. We're in the process of a shift handover at the present time in Mission Control. Flight Director Glenn Lunny is replacing Flight Director Milton Windler. The capsule communicator on the upcoming shift will be astronaut Joe Kerwin. At the present time, Apollo 13 is 131,712 nautical miles from Earth. The spacecraft velocity is up now to 4,928 feet per second. Repeating a figure passed along a little while ago, flight dynamics officer reports that as a result of the mid-course correction, the flight path angle at entry is within the entry corridor. The flight path angle currently appears to be minus 6.24 degrees at entry interface. The nominal flight path angle is 6.5. And that is what the mid-course correction was targeted for. 6.24, negative 6.24 degrees is within the entry corridor, and a decision has not been made at this time as to whether any subsequent mid-course corrections will be required. At 112 hours, 51 minutes, this is Mission Control, Houston. This is Apollo Control at 112 hours, 55 minutes. ECOM, the command module electrical and environmental control engineer, reported that the power transfer to the command module main bus B is continuing to function smoothly, and the battery charging operation also progressing well at this time.
We can see Santa Barbara to the right.
Three entry batteries aboard the command module is being recharged, and ECOM reports that it appears to be taking a charge well. At 112 hours, 56 minutes, Apollo 13 is 131,426 nautical miles from Earth, traveling at a speed of 4,935 feet per second. And we're now 29 hours, 44 minutes from re-entry.
Aquarius Houston, over. Okay, this is your friendly do-it-yourself kit con with a suggested procedure on the lithium hydroxide situation. You're looking good.
Do it yourself, Capcom.
And you do have sufficient LEM poop to last you the rest of the flight. However, being on the conservative side, we would like to use one more set of command module canisters to guard against some possible problem with the LEM primary canister. And I have a simplified procedure.
Oh, great.
Hey, I think I read that you were ready. Absolutely beautiful. This simply consists of getting a second pair of cartridges out of the command module, putting one band of sticky tape, that is of the gray tape with the sticky side out, around the sides of each new canister near the top, taking a piece of EVA cue card and cutting it into four squares about 2 or 3 inches on a side, bending those at a right angle to form corner supports, attaching them to the sticky tape so that they'll stick up and overlap the old canister, and then simply putting the old canister next to the new canister and taping it up real good so it sticks together. The only other procedure is to remove the towel plug from the old cartridges and put it in the bottom of the new cartridge. And that's it. Over. Okay, Fred, I think you got it. I didn't completely copy your...
It was so garbled trying to hear what they said, I couldn't include it.
The top of the new cartridge against the bottom of the old
one. I mean, part of it is just, it's really staticky, but also the tapes don't make it sound any better. There was a huge gap between when they were recorded and when they were digitized, so some quality was lost.
Listening, ECOM told me that he'd like another battery charging readout.
Houston, Aquarius.
Aquarius, Houston, go.
You want us to start on this lithium mod now, Joe, or when do you have time?
It's not time critical, Fred, but if you have the people awake now, you might go ahead and do it.
The shadow on the aft body is really annoying me.
You probably know this, but
gonna have to look up how to fix these jagged shadows. I've looked it up before and didn't get a very satisfactory answer.
Readout on the AMSA bolts.
All right,
copy that, Fred. Thank you very much. 38.9 and 1.9. And Econ.
Okay,
is,
to the right are the cities of Ventura and Oxnard.
And, to verify the amount of amps we're putting back in the battery. That's why he wants it at half-hour intervals. If that schedule begins to interfere seriously with your rest cycle or so, give us a call, over.
This is Apollo Control, 113 hours, 28 minutes, ground elapsed time. The black team of flight controllers is presently taking over here in Mission Control Center. We're estimating about 15 minutes for the change of shift press briefing with Maroon Team Flight Director Milton Wendler.
A bit of a pause, probably loading stuff at Los Angeles and everything.
It appears that this shift will be primarily a sleep shift with a few minor items to be taken care of by the crew, such as attaching additional
Sirius Mountains
lithium hydroxide canisters to the devices that were fabricated on board the spacecraft yesterday. Instead of taking the canisters out, they'll simply attach
another one. Okay, I think we're through the choppiness. So Oxnard, there's Oxnard.
Attached to the suit hoses. Presently, Apollo 13, 129,791 nautical miles out from Earth, approaching at a velocity of 4,977 feet per second. At 113 hours, 30 minutes, ground elapsed time and standing by, this is Apollo Control.
Aquarius Houston, go ahead.
Okay, we got one of them rigged, Joe, and looks like we can do a pretty good job just using the thin strips first combined to put together and then just using the sticky paper up inside. We've got a pretty good feel that way without even using the cardboard.
Hey, okay, Fred, we suspected that you'd gotten at least one on. We've noticed a partial pressure drop from 1.8 to 0.8, which is real good.
Okay, you might run that by the CCD and just to improve our inbound mod.
Roger that. Aquarius, Houston.
Go ahead, Joe.
Roger, we're convening the CPCB on that change, Fred, but flight has given you an interim go-ahead. Over.
This is Apollo Control.
In front of us is the city of Thousand Oaks.
Press conference. Milton Wendler, the Maroon Team flight director, is now en route to the main auditorium. Should be starting within the next few minutes. This is Apollo Control.
Not too bad, Fred.
Okay, we've got both canisters completed now.
Okay, roger that, Fred, and you're reading 0.1 again on the CO2. Incidentally, are you guys having good luck getting water out of the command module?
We hadn't tried that yesterday.
Okay.
Yeah, this is quite an apparatus hanging on to these hoses now.
ready to see it designed and looked at it as some of the things. But it sure seems to work.
Roger that. And Aquarius Houston, your convenience, we'd like another volts and amps readout.
Okay. How do your reads go?
Pretty good, Fred.
Okay, volts 39.0.
Can barely see it past the mountains, or maybe not even see it at all, but Malibu Beach is to our right. In the city of Malibu. And we can more or less see Los Angeles and the airport from here. I think he said, sorry, my bad there, but I'm not sure. Early use of that phrase. Choppy around here.
Did that PTCO2 drop? Go on Colorado, you know, how fast
is it? Okay, Jack, the plot shows you about 130,000 miles out, which is about 10,000 closer than you were when I came on a couple hours ago. And let me check with Fido for your rate of closure. Hey, Jack, over.
Quiet.
Your smiling Fido says you're making 5,040 in a 5,000 mile zone.
They're full of jokes today.
Aquarius Houston, over.
This is the town of Topanga.
Roger, Jack. Hate to keep
looks nice.
But, we would like a,
and there's Topanga State Park, too. Or, Topanga might have been past. Ooh, sorry. Might have been back there. Still, Topanga State Park, and then it is some other town. I think for the sake of a smooth landing, I need my little plug-in.
This is Apollo Control, 114 hours, 46 minutes, ground elapsed time.
Might be helpful.
Rather quiet at the present time. Very little communications with the spacecraft. Which now is 126,029 nautical miles out from Earth. Approach velocity 5,076 feet per second. Electrical power usage hovering around 12, 13 amps. Partial pressure of carbon dioxide in the lunar module cabin, now 1/10 of a millimeter of mercury. The addition of the two command module lithium hydroxide scrubber canisters to the homemade device rigged up yesterday by the crew of Apollo 13 has reduced this quantity of carbon dioxide from slightly over 1 millimeter back down to 1/10. Apollo 13 total weight standing at 87,740 pounds. Here goes a call, I believe, to the spacecraft.
Okay, I think I should go into the cockpit now.
Apparently it was an accidental nudge of the keying switch in the spacecraft communicator's console, causing the familiar beep-beep sound.
Beep-beep.
And some other spacecraft onboard readings are showing now 33.17 pounds of oxygen in the descent stage, 2.25 pounds in ascent tank 1, 2.67 pounds ascent tank 2. Water quantities. Descent 51.9 pounds. Ascent tank 1, 42.1. Ascent tank 2, 42.1 pounds. Cabin pressure 4.98 pounds per square inch. Showing a temperature of 51 degrees, which is at the measurement is taken at the outlet and does not represent the free air temperature in the cabin, which is probably up around 70.
Okay. All right, so to see the airport
as
there.
Earlier,
a little bit low, it seems.
Gross weight of both vehicles is now 87,740 pounds. Of this weight, 58,728 pounds.
Gear down.
Rocket propellant, about 29 tons. This computes out to 67% of the total vehicle weight and propellants. Apollo 13
okay.
Is the fifth time that a manned spacecraft has made the return from the moon. Apollo 8 back in December of 68 was a somewhat conservative approach using the command and service module only, and going into lunar orbit, having quite a large margin of propellant available to go into lunar orbit and to make the trans-Earth injection out of lunar orbit back toward Earth. Apollo 10, the all-up spacecraft, went into lunar orbit, did everything but the actual landing, including the descent orbit down to about 8 miles above the moon, but stopped short of making the descent. Here again, there were adequate margins of propellant. And with Apollo 11, the landing was made, and Apollo 12 is essentially a repeat as far as the amount of propellants and the spacecraft performance were concerned. At any rate, all of these had smaller amounts smaller quantities of propellant available than Apollo 13 does at the present time. The service propulsion system propellant on Apollo 13 stands untapped at 40,796 pounds.
Right, it's cheating to say this has the most propellant when
Delta V or velocity change.
Well, the service modules rendered useless and they didn't make orbit around the moon.
Vehicle combinations, not just command service module alone, but in some cases.
Okay, okay. Please stop with the message. It's distracting.
Where you had the total LEM and command module combination. And others, the trans-Earth injection burn, where only the command and service module would use up some 3,147 feet per second. There are 11,093 pounds of descent propulsion propellant remaining. However, not all of this is available since the helium burst disk relief valve blew during the night. There's about 800 feet per second blowdown or hullage volume in the descent propulsion tanks. So not all of this 11,000 pounds are available. In the untapped asset...
Okay, we are here.
...tanks, we have 5,242 pounds loaded. Service module reaction control system, 1,342 pounds are still relatively untapped, except for the small attitude usage that was made during the translunar coast prior to the...
All right, let's get to the next taxiway. Very nice flight. Not too bad lag around Los Angeles, considering it is Los Angeles, so...
still a sealed dual ring system.
Could be worse.
Command module for attitude control during entry. There are 245 pounds of propellant available there. When the service module and lunar module are jettisoned prior to entry, approximately 29 tons of what is jettisoned to enter the atmosphere and burn up will be propellant.
Okay, I think I'm going to pause that audio right there, as the PAO does a recap of all the missions and how much propellant they had. And we gotta slow down here. Well, not reversers, sorry. Alright, I'm gonna continue taxiing. But we have arrived at LAX, and next flight we are going to go to Phoenix, and I'm gonna try out the MC-130. That should be interesting. So yeah. With that, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this flight. If you did, please do press like. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below, and I'll see you next time.